Hi, today I'm going to show you how to put together the leprechaun hat. So we'll start with the top. That's the top of the hat, and these are the 10 panels. So with each panel, I went through and folded over the tabs on the score lines and also curled them over a little bit so you can get that little curve when you create the hat. So you keep on doing that with all 10 first just to make sure they're ready to go for assembly. Now that the panels are all ready to go, we're going to start gluing them together. So you can glue all three put glue on all three side tabs. And tongue tied. Then always add it to the top one first. Hold it for a couple seconds or more depending on your glue, just to anchor it, and then just gently guide it down around the edge, making sure that edge is aligned with the tab fold. You kind of can put your finger there to make sure that it's not sticking out too much. And I always have a little wet paper towel to gather the excess glue because I am heavy-handed. So you'll continue around the edges the same, starting with the first. And you can always be a little careful with the glue, making sure it's not too close to the edge of the fold. I always intend to do that, but that's not always the result. And just continue to just guide it down, making sure that panel edge matches up with the tab fold and apply pressure from within. So just continue to add each edge until you get to the very last closure, and I will talk you through it. But for now, just enjoy watching me put together all the other sides. Thank you. So now we're on that last tab. So you kind of can hold it open with your fingers, just like I'm showing. And then get those last three tabs. And the reason I'm showing it is sometimes it gets a little bit wonky at the end when you have to kind of hold it open. So I wanted to show you how I did it. And then just carefully attach each tab. It is hard sometimes getting that first one going because it kind of wants to snap in. But anything like this, when you get to the last one, when you have to close it, it's a little bit difficult. Just be patient with yourself and make sure you put enough glue that it's kind of wet enough just in case you are delayed. And you can see I kind of didn't go all the way down, but it's not a big deal. I mean, I didn't match it completely right at the top. And you can see how it's glued inside. And just make sure it's secure before you go on to the next step. So now we'll just anchor on one side of the top of the hat. Just add glue to one tab. And then line up an edge. Make sure it's lined up properly to that tab fold. And just apply pressure from within. We want to do that because it'll be easier putting the rest of the tabs. And what I like to do with this type of an assembly, if I choose to put it on just without it being attached at the beginning, I usually glue the opposite tab, or an opposite tab if there is one exactly cross. Then you have two anchored, and then it'll be easier to glue the rest in. Because you can reach in, do a better job than me. I was just having an issue today. And then just go ahead and apply pressure against the table. Now you have the remaining tabs. You just want to flip up and add glue underneath. And then you'll just glue them. You can just apply pressure to the table. For some reason I missed a little video on this, but just apply glue underneath and apply pressure down, and the top will be assembled just like you're seeing. You can do your best to make sure that those edges hit the tab folds. Now that the top of the hat is ready to go, we are going to start on the edge. So you can see I folded one already. The edge of the hat, or the brim, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to fold these on the score lines, and I'm kind of curving them a little bit too. You could do it after you assemble, but it's up to you. And go ahead and we're going to fold down those tabs, but those tabs are going to actually fold up to glue inside the top of the hat. So I'll show that to you in a minute. But for now, we'll just attach one side of the brim. Unfortunately, the way I did it, it's not that noticeable, but the edges, these are the front and back edges of the hat. It's just the way that I created the brim. So now when I talked about those inner tabs, even though we folded it down, I'll be ending up folding them up to glue to the inside edge of the upper hat piece. So just go around, and folding them down first helps, and then folding them up. You could potentially put your paper upside down when you cut it. That probably doesn't help by the time you're watching this, but it's not a big deal. I do it all the time. Sometimes we have to fold the other way, and the machine only obviously cuts one way. So I chose not to glue it together first before I put the top on, but you could. Some people find it easier, so it's really up to you. So go ahead and add glue to one of the first ones. I always try to match up an edge on the top to the edge to where I put it together on the top versus the brim to start, but it doesn't matter. It's up to you. The top is symmetrical. You see I'm kind of aligning that tab to that side and then applying pressure. And once that's anchored in, we can add all the other tabs. You can see how it looks inside. Again, if you wanted to glue that brim, I've seen people, other people assemble hats where they glue the rim part of the, or the brim of the hat first, the whole thing, so it's circular, and then they glue the inside. Sometimes I'm not so eloquent with my fingers, so I have to do it a little bit different. So I always show you a way it will work. Whenever you work with cut files, just because I put it together that way doesn't mean there's not another way to put it together. I actually select a way to assemble it that I feel might be easier for most, and I go with it. So my decision is usually based after a couple attempts of assembling the same file. This is not my first time. I do lots of tests before I videotape it and or finish the design, because it's important for me to make it easy to put together. So if you see I'm using a fine tip applicator, that does help. You can kind of bend it back either way. But if you started right, it should align properly. It might get off a little bit as you go along, but it's not a huge deal. Usually it's not that noticeable. That's why I always start with like the back of a design first, to attach it first. So if I do make kind of a alignment issue, it's not that noticeable when you're looking at it. It's the same here. And if you do make this, go ahead and share on our Facebook page or Instagram, or you can tag us on Instagram using the tag Simply Crafty SVGs. I always love to see what people make with my files. If you're still listening to me through this video, I'm not a designer by trade for these years. I've learned it over the years. I'm self-taught, so I have a lot to learn. Sometimes I get better over time. I'm hoping I do, at least. And if you ever have edges that are just kind of rough on the edge, or you didn't glue it right, that's where chalks or inks kind of help, if you've ever chalked or inked edges. I do it all the time to hide little blemishes. Of course, crafts are not meant to be perfect, so they're handmade, they're fun. So you get to this last piece here, and you'll want to glue that tab underneath. So the way that I did it is I glued the inside tab, the last tab, to the inside of the top of the hat first. Made sure that was nice and secure, and then I glued that bottom piece underneath. You don't want to see it on the top. Now, I was a little bit off. That's why I said I start at the back of the thing. I glued that side a little bit further down than I should have. That's why it looks a little wonky. I'm not going to restart it. This is just life. This is what happens when you do paper crafts. Sometimes most often it's not perfect, but it's perfect the way it is. And you can't see me gluing it. I went out of view, but I just glued that last tab, which really completes the hat in all essence. The next step we're going to do, we're going to add the panels, which are optional if you like it just plain old green. And I'm just curling the brim a little bit so it goes up on the sides. You can do that or keep it flat, but you can add these panels, or you don't have to. It's up to you. I think the panels are kind of fun. So just go ahead. I'm only going to show you a couple panels, but you can go ahead. They all go on the same way. Be light with the paper. With the glue on the paper, if you're using like a thin paper like I did. And I usually just kind of, they have an edge around. They'll have a border around each. I kind of just carefully put them on and rub them down and make sure that I put enough pressure on the panel so they stay. If you're using a cardstock or a heavier paper, I used a real lightweight pattern paper, you probably will have to apply a little bit more pressure and rub it a little bit harder. you just continue around, and then we'll add the band after that. But like I said, if you don't want to add the panels, you can just go ahead and just add the hat band, which I did two versions, one with the panels and one without the panels. So now we're just going to jump ahead to all the panels being on. And that's the back, so I'm going to go to the front. And we're going to add that little band. Now, it's supposed to sit up just a little bit up, so dry fit it to make sure you know where you're going to place it. And don't put glue too close to the edge so you can move it if you don't have it in the right space when you glue it. So you can see you just fold it in all the scores. And I'm just going to start with the end piece, or a couple pieces. I glued, two or three? Don't do a whole lot. If you want to do two at once or one, it's just to help you place it first. So again, it needs to be just a little bit up. It looks like about 0.5 inches or so. But you can see, gauge it from the folds. And once you have it in the right place, all the folds should sit and match up with the folds on the hat. The reason I say to do it a couple tabs at a time is if I've done this in the past where I tried to glue on the whole thing at once and it gets all skewed. So this helps to keep it straight as you place it on. So there's two pieces. This is the first piece. And just continue gluing it around the hat. And again, just trying to match up the folds in the band with the folds in the hat. And then you'll add the second piece. I put a little tab there so it overlaps. It's not a big deal. Just put it on until it's secure. And then you'll want to match up that second piece. And continue around. Now if you want, I didn't do this, but if you want, you can always do one side and the other side just to make sure they match up as you go around. But again, if you only do a couple sections at a time, then you should be okay. See, I kind of left that last section. If you continue to go around and fold it around those sections, the hat sections, making sure those folds match up, and you can see, visually, you should be able to see the same kind of width below. Then eventually you'll get to that piece where it matches up where you started, and it should match up exactly. And that's why we're not putting glue on it, because if it doesn't, you can do a little adjustment at the end. And as you can see, it matches up fairly well. So that's pretty simple. Then once that's secure, we'll add that front leprechaun little buckle piece. You could put really whatever you want, but I added a little buckle piece where we just need to piece it together first. So you can see that little clover. Just sits right in the middle of that. You can call it a buckle. I kind of call it a buckle. I did another hat with gold on the background, which looks really cute. This one I kept all green. Now, because it's going to sit on a curve, because that, you know, the front and back of the hat's where the seam is on the brim, since it sits in the curve, you have to figure out how you're going to glue it on. So I felt like the best medium adhesive for me to use was not liquid glue, but glue dots. So here I have some mini glue dots. Just add them to the back, and then we'll just attach it to the front of the hat. I just lined it up in the middle, three dots. You can kind of curl it, but you can't really do it with glue, but However you can get it to attach. And just put it on how you like. That's it. It's not quite big enough for an adult head once it's finished. Be a fun decoration, but I did wear it. You could wear it. It's just smaller. It's like a 5.5 inches wide at the widest inside. I think it's fun. It would just be fun for a St. Patrick's Day party. Well, I hope you enjoyed this project, and I thank you for watching.